Good morning, children. Welcome to social class. And we know that I'm explaining a lesson that's in our history, 13th unit, democratic revolutions between the time of 17, 18, and also that 19th century. In this lesson, so first of all, before of starting today's topic, I'm going to be revise what we learned in this lesson in the previous class. So we know that how England became an independent. So a long years before, England is ruled by Stuart dynasty and also called as Tudor dynasty. They are called as kings, and they have some problem with the parliament and also that popes. Finally, the parliament, they got victory on England, means monarch, and they implemented constitutional monarchy. It means the king should follow the advices from the parliament. Without any influence of the parliament, the king cannot implement any rule. Finally, how English became an independent. So we know that English Revolution are called Glorious Revolution, otherwise called Bloodless Revolution. So without shedding one drop of blood, the England became an independent. So that is in the first we learn about English Revolution. Then come to that next one is American Revolution. So first, after the 16th century, at the time of 17th century, lot of people from Europe, those who were not happy with the present existing system in the European countries, they all are migrated to the America. They cleared the forest, they constructed buildings, palaces, forts, temples, churches, mosques and everything. So these are the people of different European countries. They went to this in America and they developed that American continent. After the development, the English rulers, they entered. They are saying that this is our country and you have to follow our rules. So because of this, all the factors, a lot of regions, Americans asking for no taxation without representations. Because even though they are the main persons, even though they are paying a tax, but there is no having that voting rights. So they came with the slogan, you can say that no taxation without representation. After a long struggle, the American, the 13 colonies of America, they start the war against of English government with the support of French. Finally, America defeated British and they became an independent. We know that how America and English, they both are independent. They got that independence. Now come to that next topic. It's about French Revolution. First of all, we should know that where the French comes. French are also called as France. This France comes under European continent. The capital of France was Paris. And if you observe that, what the story of France, now I'm going to be explaining that. In 1774, the French comes under the control of Louis XVI. Louis XVI are called as 16th Louis. He became the King of France in 1774. After becoming a king, he supported that America to become an independent. Who supported America? So Louis XVI supported America to become an independent because Louis XVI or a French believes that England was the common enemy of England England was the common enemy of France and USA. So they supported in the war because of support of French only that America became an independent. Because of support, the treasury of France became an empty. Treasury means what? The money or financial position of France was become an empty because this France supported America in the war. When the treasury was become an empty, then they will think about sources of income. Because for any country, the source of income was taxes. Through the taxes only, they'll get that money. Similarly, the France also, they're trying for to increase the taxes. If any country, once upon a time, at the time of 16th, 17th, 18th century, if they want to increase the taxes, they have a system. Here also in the region of France, they have a system for increasing the taxes. Then I will explain that what is the how to increase the taxes in the country. Before of that, we have to know the position of France. And also, because the, what purpose they require the money? They require the money for the purpose of to run the palace, the king's palace. Next, to run the court administration, the court, and also for paying the employee tax, that you can say that employee salaries, the army salaries, for all the things he required that money. That is the first position of Louis XVI at the time of 1774 after. Now see that society, position of society, otherwise called as socio-economic conditions. French society, France society was divided into three estates. The people of French divided into three estates. The first estate, second estate, and also called as third estate. You see that first estate people, second estate people, third estate people in our country, we have it based upon the caste, or any based upon the division, we have some different type of division. But in the region of French at the time of 18th century, the people of French divided into three estates, first estate, second estate, third estate. The first estate consisting with the clergy. Clergy means those who have a link up with the churches. So first estate people, that is called as clergy people. Second estate people is called as nobility. Nobility means landlords, feudals. So the administrative unit people is called as nobility. Nobility is the second group. Third group is called as common people, and also the businessmen, merchants, and court officials, lawyers, peasants. Peasants means farmers, that is artisans, and small peasants, and laborers, shopkeepers. These all the people is comes in the third unit. In the French society, the third group of people consisting that 90% is balanced, 10% of people is having that these two group, that is 10% of the society is having that first and second, and third estate people is having that 90% of the people. And one more thing is, even though majority people in French society was third estate, but they don't have that any respect, any privilege means values, and every tax is paid by third estate, not for the first and also the second estate. Even this 90% of the total population belongs to the third estate, and maximum land, that you can say that 60% of the land is having and by the, that you can say that churches. So the French, in the region of French, 60% of the land, it is comes under the control of churches. Even the balanced land is also having by the third estate rich people, not for the poor peasants. So that is also one of the problem. Even that majority people, the peasants, not only working under the other members, and they have to work for the kings, and they have to work for other that you can say that nobility without paying that money. It means the society of French was very difficult, and every work and everything should be comes under the control of first and second only, and third estate people, they don't have that any privileges, any respect, any values. So these all the third estate people, they are struggling much. And also there are some different type of taxes. The tax name is called a tithe, T-I-T-H-E-H, tithe. This is a tax is collected by a church from the third estate people. So every person of third estate, they have to pay a tax to the government. That is called tithe. So the tithe is a tax collected by the churches of French. So the churches of the French, they are collecting from the people of third estate, that you can say the tithe. There is one more tax is called tithe. T-A-I-L-L-E, the tithe. The tithe is a tax, is a direct tax collected by the government from the third estate. So because of all the things, the people of French, common people, peasants, these all the members, their struggles, they are not happy under the control of government. Now see that small subtopic, name is called as growing middle class. What the third topic is called as growing middle class. So because of development of industries, that you can say that silk industries, woolen industry and other manufacturing industries. So because of the development of industries, there is a third section was formed, that you can say that middle class group was formed, and these are the middle class group is also consisting with, there are some different type of, because middle class people is also comes under the third estate. We know that in the region of third estate, people like lawyers, philosophers, professional people, in the engineers, and everyone is comes under the third estate, that you can say that middle class people. So these are the middle class people, they are inspiring the ideology of famous philosophers. See that one of the famous philosopher name is called as John Locke, is a one famous philosopher. And other philosopher name is called as Rousseau. And other philosopher name is called as Montesquieu. So these are the philosophers. You see one more time how the middle class group was emerged. Middle class group was emerged with the development of industries and industrialization, that is manufacturing industries, silk industries, and also the woolen industries. Because of development of these all the industries, new section of the people, that you can say the third estate was increased. That you can say that middle class people working in these industries like labor, servants, scholars, some of the officers. And we know the third estate consisting with some philosophers, engineers, lawyers, court officials, all the members. And these are the intellectuals and literates and educated persons are inspired with some great philosophers like John Locke and Jean-Jacques Rousseau and also called as Montesquieu. And these are the members, they mention some different type of books based upon the government systems. See that John Locke's the book name is called as Two Treatises of Government. If you observe that in the book of Two Treatises of Government, he was against of absolute power of monarchy. So, who was against of monarchy? Monarchy means kingship. So, in our French Revolution, French lesson, who is a monarch? Louis XVI was the monarch. So, John Locke is a great philosopher and the people of third estate, almost all the intellectuals, they are inspired with the ideology of John Locke. And he mentioned one thing in the book, name is called Two Criticizes of Government. In the book, he was mentioned that he was opposed to the monarchy. So don't give a chance for the king and people only can rule the country. That is the main intention of the Locke's ideology. Come to that, John Rousseau. In book, he was mentioned that social contrast. And he was given in the book of social contrast, all the people of a country, they have a right to vote, to elect the representatives. It means present days in every country, we are following that, that you can say that right to vote. In that right to vote, every people, they have a chance to elect the representative. Similarly, Rousseau is in the book of social contrast. He was mentioned that every person should have a right to elect their member through the vote. So that is called a social contrast in the book of social contrast. Let's see that the spirit of laws. This is mentioned by Montesquieu. In the book of Montesquieu, he was mentioned that powers of distribution, that you can say that legislative, executive, and also called as judiciary. Present days, every country is following that legislative system, executive system, judiciary system. So Montesquieu, in the book of The Spirit of Laws, he was given that powers, how the powers are called as laws, is going to be divided between legislative, executives, and judiciary. That we learn in the class 8. Now see that next small subtopic is about how the revolution was outbroke. So the outbreak of revolution, see on 5th May 1789, Louis XVI won that money, and that money can collect through the taxes. So the reason he wants to increase the taxes, then the country's income can be increased. Because of that factor, he was going for elections. See that if the assembly is like that, we know that there are the king can be sit here. This is a monarch chair, and this is called as estate one people. This is called as estate two people, and this is called as estate three people. So on 5th May 1789, Louis XVI called for meeting for increasing the taxes. So the reason, from estate 3, there are 300 members they sat here, sitting, not for standing, sitting. And estate 2, that is also from second estate, from here also 300 representatives, they are sitting that side. So this side and this side, both side, they are sitting by the first estate and also the third estate. And here 600 members from the third estate. But these people, they don't have the sitting, they have to stand till the meeting is going to be conducted. See in your textbook how the picture was mentioned. On this side and this side, they are sitting. And the complete other sides, they are standing. So when the meeting was held, Louis XVI, and for this reason wants to be increase the taxes, for the reason is going for voting system. Once upon a time, the voting system is estate 1 having 1 vote, estate 2 is having 1 vote, and estate 3 is having that 1 vote. Actually, we know that estate 1 and 2, the total population of a French was only 10%, and they are asking for 2 votes. And estate 3, they have the total population is 90%, they have only the 1 vote. So the king of France, that is Louis XVI, he wants to go for voting with the same system which is going to be conducted once upon a time in the previous days. But third estate was not accepted because they are the taxpayers and they are the important one, and these are the people they are demanding that, like a Rousseau ideology, that you can say the social contract. It means everyone should have the voting right, not for the estate one right, it is for people. So one people, one vote, one person, one vote, through that voting system that is demanding by third estate. But the king of France was not accepted for the reason this, all the people, they are dispersed from that area. So they came from that area because they boycotted. And what they did after boycotting? So these are the members they met in the region of the tennis court. So on 20th June 1789, members from the third estate, that you can say that Mirabeau, Abyssias and Bailly. So these all the members, those who disperse it from the third estate, when the meeting is going on, they met in the tennis court that you can found in the region of Versailles. Versailles is a place that you can found in the region of Paris. On 20 June 1789, under the leadership of Mirabeau and Abyssias and Bailly, and they met in the tennis court, they decided to form the National Assembly. They decided to form that National Assembly, and also they decided to prepare the constitution, and this constitution should be based upon equality, freedom and right to opportunities for all the members with the democratic ideology. And these are the members, so they formed the National Assembly and they decided they want to prepare the constitution, and without preparation of the constitution they don't want to disperse from this area. So that is the main intention of these members, and they decided to prepare the constitution for the region of France. Afterwards, when these all are very busy, so there is a one biggest problem is happened in the region of France. Extreme weather. You can say that extreme winter. Because of extreme winter, severe winter, that you can say that cold was striking and the crop was failed. When the crop was failed, automatically the prices of the bread was increased, and the bakers, we know that bakers means bakery owners, they taken the opportunity and they wanted to be increase the prices. When the prices of the bread was increased, lot of women on the road, they are forming a line for the purpose of buying the bread because shortage of bread, and that is common because of the crop was failed and bakers was misused this power. And these are the women, they are forming the biggest queue line on the road. When this one is happened, the position is not good, and women, those angry women, they forcefully they enter the shops, they broken the shops. When this one is happened, the King Louis system, they sent an army to stop this all the activities. When this one is happened, the people of French, those who are doing the revolution, they went to that Bastille, the name of the prison where they can find a lot of prisoners. So all those people, they were gone to the Bastille and they broken that doors of the Bastille prison. Lot of prisoners they came out, and these are the situations that you can find at the time of French Revolution in the region of France at the time of 1789. When this one is happened, King was accepted to form the National Assembly, and means to recognize the National Assembly, and also accepted the limited power of King, and accepted to give power to the constitution also. And also that feudals also, they gave that rights of land, and they reduced the powers of clergy and feudals, and king's power is also reduced. So this is the position is happened after the people attacked that Bastille prison and people attacked the shop. This is all the angry situation that is happened in the region of French. Now see that France become that constitutional monarch. How the French become the constitutional monarch? So you see there is a one picture is given in your textbook. This is in a picture. And once if you observe that in 1791, National Assembly was accepted by the ruler and king's power is also limited. So now the king should be work under the control of the constitution. That we can say the constitutional monarch. So later the people of France, the third estate, the intellectuals, they decided to divide the society into three. One is saying that active citizens and also called as passive citizens. What is mean by active and what is mean by passive? Active means the person, those who have the voting right. Passive means the person, those who don't have the voting right. Those who have a voting right is called as active citizens. Those who don't have the voting right is called passive citizens. So those who have the voting right, their age is minimum 25 years. And less than 25 years are called as passive citizens. And also next one is based upon the wealth. Those who are paying a tax, and the tax should be minimum 3 days of wages. So if a labor is working an outside, is earning for 150 rupees per day, for 3 days it is called as 450 rupees, and if a tax is more than 450 only, the labor is going to get that voting right. So based upon the taxpayers, and that is minimum 3 days of payment of wages, and also person should be crossed 25 years of age, and also women is also not accepting to give the voting right. So women, children, and those who are not paying a tax, for them there is no voting right. So remaining all the people, they have the voting right. If you watch this one, judge is comes under judiciary. Before only I was given an example of Montesquieu. The country are laws based upon the three, that you can say the legislative, executives and judiciary. Judiciary is leading by judge. Executive leading by king and ministers. Legislative leading by National Assembly consisting with 745 members and electing by 50,000 men, that is active men. Actually active citizens in the region of French was 28 millions, and also passive citizens was 3 millions about the women's children. This all the members. And one more thing is, they gave the rights of the people based upon the equality, freedom and equal opportunities. There are 17 rights was made. Once read in your textbook, they gave that 10 rights, and these are the 10 rights is based upon the equality, freedom and respect, and also opportunities for all the members. So that is it, one of the topic. Now see the course of revolt. Now the people, the reformers, those who are not happy with the National Assembly, because National Assembly consisting with the professional people like lawyers and some different type of administrative people and intellectuals, they did not give any chance for the peasants, because peasants are the members. Even at the time of increasing the taxes, there are 600 members from all the third estate, and also they accepted 40,000 letters. So at the time, peasants supported, but there is no peasants in the National Assembly, and this is in a position the people maximum was not happy for National Assembly. When the people is not happy, so they decided to form some different type of clubs. Club means group of people, they form together and they will share their ideology and they want to be fight against of the government. Similarly, there are some different type of peoples, reformers, those who want to change, they form that some different type of clubs. In that all the clubs, there is a one club is called as Jacobin club. So this is a Jacobin club, was the important club, and this club was succeeded to remove the kings and National Assembly members. And this Jacobin club, consisting with the members of peasants, shopkeepers and shoemakers, pastry cooks and also watchmakers, printers, these are some different type of daily labors are the members of this Jacobin club. In 1792, this Jacobin club planned to revolt against of the Paris, and also they want to attack to the ruler. So on this aspect, the people of Jacobin club, they attacked a palace name is called as Tuileries, where the king can forge. And there are some different members of Jacobin club, they attacked the Tuileries, and they killed that king's guards. They killed that king's guards, and they taken that king's hostage for several hours. Hostage means keep like a kidnap. For some of the times they stop the king for doing their works. But this one is happened that National Assembly, they impressioned the royal family. When this one is happened after a few days, and National Assembly is also dissolved. Instead of National Assembly, and Jacobin club, and all the members, they gone for votes. In this wars, the people accepted the Jacobins. So Jacobin, after coming that, they given a voting right for 21 years people without seeing that richness, without seeing that taxpayers. They given voting right for the people, those who have a 21 years of age. But here also women's and children is not having the voting rights. So afterwards, instead of National Assembly, they formed the convention. And this convention led by Jacobins, and the Jacobins is called as Robespierre, is the leader of Jacobin club. Now see the region of terror. So one more time, this is somewhat easy only, but in 1791, those who are not happy with the National Assembly, there are some different type of reformers, including with the people, they form the groups, and the groups are called clubs. There are some important different type of clubs. One of the important club at the time was Jacobin club, and this Jacobin club is always working for the development of the people. And in this one, common people like daily laborers, shoemakers, watchmakers, even that pastry cookers, some different type of people are the members of Jacobin club. And these are the angry people, they decided to attack to the king. So they attacked to the Tuileries where the king was staying, and then they killed that guards. Finally, National Assembly is also decided to cancel that, and they arrested that royal family members. After arresting, the National Assembly is also dissolved, they gone for votes. Here they gave voting right for 21 years of age people, those who are without seeing any wealth and the richness, just by seeing the age, they given the voting right to the people except children and also the women. So later Jacobins, the convention was formed, the group, and they are ruled the country. This is called as region of terror. So this is called as 1793 to 1794. The period is called as Jacobin club, and this Jacobin club was ruled the country for 2 years of time. Here the what is that Jacobins club? So Jacobin club and Robespierre was the leader of Jacobin club, and this policy was very strict. If any person or any member is not going to be follow the policies, so they are going to be imprisoned and they are going to be killed. Here is the strict and blind policies. So first, I will attack to the nobles and also the clergy. Even that if any person is own people is also, they become against to the Jacobins club, they will become that, they will decide them as a Gulishan. The person, those who are doing any mistake is called as Gulishan. Once if you have done the mistake, then you'll keep like that, under that they will kill, they will remove the heads. So in this aspect, you'll give that equal bread, equal means equal food for all the members. So there is no difference. All the rules was very strict. And this 2 years, that is the time between the time of 1793 to 1794 time, the country will rule by Robespierre, the leader of Jacobins club, very strict and with a very powerful. Finally, after in 1794, court executed that Robespierre and they decided him as a Gulishan. Finally, Robespierre government was ended. So we'll see that list, the balance topic, and you learned today about French Revolution, the Society of French, and how the National Assembly was formed, and different type of philosophers' ideology, and how the Constitution was formed, and what is the role of Robespierre, Jacobins club, these are all the things. So we'll see the next class about the balance lesson. Thank you. Thank you.